Bathroom break, anyone? 4 seconds left? No?
Okay.
We're starting on a beautiful note here today with the stars of Dead of Summer. It's good to see you guys.
Thank you.
Welcome. You. Welcome to the MTV Grotto Cave, whatever you want to call it.
It's the grotto.
I just came up with that. That sounds
really
totally wrong.
Like, this rolls back. Yeah. Really great hot sauce.
I was like, whoa. Okay.
I basically sleep here every night. This turns into a bed.
It's actually really comfy.
You don't sleep. Don't lie.
I don't. They don't let me sleep here. Congratulations on the show, guys. Just debuted a few weeks ago. This must be exciting because this is kind of like your first opportunity in a way to kind of like meet the fans like in a concentrated environment.
You know, like orange juice.
Yes. Not from concentrate. Concentrate. Have you been looking forward to this, or are you scared about this, or what?
Oh,
give me a
great
sense.
Yeah. Comic-Con's my Christmas, man.
Yeah. Have you gone to Comic-Con as a fan? Yeah.
Yeah, I used to come in cosplay.
Did you
like
really?
I've come in full head to toe latex as Harley Quinn from the cartoon.
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
Is she not?
No,
so
I'm not
hot?
Kidding. But
she's hot, right?
Amazing.
I know. She's kind of
well,
amazing.
And temperature-wise, because latex doesn't
it's,
breathe.
Yeah, no,
no
that's
summer no. Latex. No,
but it was worth it.
Yeah. Totally. Someone had to cut me out of it at the end of the
right.
day. Get baby powder.
What about for you, Eli, Elizabeth? Elizabeth, you must have been here for Lost, I assume.
I've been here a lot of stuff, and I love it. So I feel the same way. I love it. But,
yeah.
But you're...
This is my first time,
yeah.
And it's actually been really, really fun. Like, even just getting off the airport, like, having people know me from this show, and, you know what I mean, have that experience, and, like, come up to us. It's just...
So great.
Yeah, man, the fans are just so fun and so
friendly
full of
and excited.
Yeah,
we're
exactly.
going to put him in latex by the end of the day. It's going to be great.
Did you know about that?
Saying,
Not the same kind of latex. But we'll get there.
You're all getting a matching latex together. It's going to be a really cute trio.
You look like a superhero. I feel like I'd probably be
or a stripper. Or it's like Magic Mike. Or like he's cosplaying as Channing Tatum.
They've got big plans for you, man. This is going to be fun.
Well, you know, look at him.
I mean... So clearly you guys don't get along. That's a shame.
Oh, right. God.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is why there's like, you know, distance between us.
I can see
yeah,
it. The body language is telling.
Oh, we are.
As soon as we leave home, don't talk to me, don't touch me.
Yeah, absolutely. Don't make eye contact.
So the nature of the show, which obviously takes place at a summer camp, mm-hmm. It would seem to be like a good bunker mentality, hopefully. You're all in this together.
Yeah.
I mean, how did you guys all meet generally like first day on set? Was there like a...
We had that dinner.
Yeah.
They brought us
usually
out,
with like, the cast, they'll do that. Yeah.
Is that scary, intimidating, just to like, even like, everyone's probably trying to get a lay of the land and
we
feel each other out?
The counselors spent about 4 days in a row where I don't think we left each other's side.
No, you guys were amazing.
We were all in one hotel and we literally like watched movies, ate food, breakfast, like
the horror
explored
film
the city.
Festivals. Yeah, they were great.
Oh, really? You watched
and
some
they were
films?
Hugely inclusive with me. So
No.
But what I mean is that it was incredible. Such great friendships. And then I got there and then I felt hugely included. It was
A lot of the cast are not. I'm a huge horror nerd. Like huge. But a lot of them haven't seen a lot of horror films and they're on a horror show. So I like made them watch a bunch of them.
You're like, here
is
your education.
Fun.
That's amazing. So
mostly because I terrified them.
So what's your short list? Like, what's the cheat sheet you give to people? Like, you need to watch these 5 movies in order to be a horror
that
maven.
That depends, because our show is very 80s and 90s tropes, whereas, like, the ones I love are, like, The Strangers and all these kind of, or The Descent and things like that.
Yeah.
And that's not really relevant to what we're doing.
Right.
So we went to another place. We went and watched, like, Scream and stuff that they hadn't seen. Or,
totally.
Like, I Know What You Did Last Summer.
I'm actually not even good with horror movies, so I would literally, like, come in, oh, it's still scary. Okay, I'm gonna go grab my food. I come back in.
I think I gotta go hunt Pokemon in the back. Sorry, guys.
You have Amber be like, oh my god.
Amber loves it.
She did love it.
Elizabeth was more weirded out at times. There were moments where she was like, no, don't kill that person. I'm like, it's a horror film.
They're going
to have to happen.
Yeah. Especially if they walk off together and they're having sex.
Never a good sign.
No. Never a good sign.
So this must be like a living kind of a dream come true for you then. If you like, I mean, you know, this is your biggest acting role to date.
Yeah,
and it's,
sure.
And it's, and it's also sounds like it's up your alley given the kind of source material, given the kind of genre it's in, you know?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's very fun, too, because there's a lot of stuff that you get to see as I hit myself in the face. And, like, you know, blood and prosthetics and stuff that I really love. I mean, I've done a horror film before. I did one for a really great guy named Fruit Chan, who did Dumplings, which is quite famous in the horror community. I'm going real nerdy right now.
No, I love it.
But I did it.
You're in the right place.
I did it because I didn't even speak in the movie. I was basically the ring girl for that movie, and I did 7 hours of prosthetic makeup every day. And it's the reason I did it is because I love that.
Yeah.
Like, that's one of my favorite things is prosthetics.
Awesome.
And practical effects. And so we do a lot of stuff on our show is practical because it's like we don't really have the budget for CGI.
Right,
so there's
like
a lot of, if you see like big waves of like blood or like things like that, that's real.
Oh yeah.
Someone
there
did
are buckets
that.
That's awesome. Of blood off stage.
You never know when you're going to need it. Just in case.
Yeah,
exactly.
Course, yeah.
And it must be exciting for you. Obviously, there was a big reveal on your character in the first episode. Were you like monitoring like the situation? Were you like on Twitter that night and like checking to see like how it went over? No.
That's a recipe for a really sad life.
It's true.
Don't ever look and see if people are critiquing you.
Right.
Yeah. I'm very open to, especially with the transgender community, I've asked them specifically to be like really open with me, because in order to do this part, I really did try and go research, and I talked to many of my friends who are trans and had them introduce me to their friends so that I could really get, you know, honest facts about what their lives were like.
Yeah.
But that said, in terms of, you know, go seeking out critique, it's dangerous and negative. Don't do it ever. I don't care what you do for a living. Don't ever do that.
The minute you type your name in on Google, that's it. Don't
do it. It's the rabbit hole you don't want to go down, right? Well, speaking of social media and stuff, and I referenced it earlier, it is that weird thing that's right now on the tip of everybody's tongue. It's either Donald Trump or Pokemon right now. We won't talk about Trump.
Both.
anybody doing Pokemon Go?
Maybe Donald Trump should do some Pokemon
It might help, maybe.
My son just asked permission for that.
And did you grant?
It's in the works. Yeah, I have to say, I'm getting pushed
for it.
Okay.
So you're enjoying it?
Yeah.
Do you see it?
Really
do you
fun.
See any Pokemon in this room?
Well, we're not talking schizophrenia. That's not, I haven't reached that level
okay,
yet.
Good, good.
I find it really fun. The interesting thing is in Vancouver, because I have an American cell phone, it's a bit like someone getting you hooked on a drug and then being like, you can't have it though. Because it's like, I'm playing it, but I can only play it when I'm on Wi-Fi.
Right.
So,
oh, that's right.
It's so cruel.
It has led to some really funny moments, though. I'll be like at a bar drinking, and I'm like, oh! Like, I caught a Vaporeon in a bar.
That's where they like to hang out.
It's like there's like a zombie apocalypse with these Pokemon Go people, because you'll be at the most random places and they'll just be walking around. Like, I was at the gym the other day.
Right.
And there was like four people just walking through the gym with their cell phones looking for Pokemon while everyone's working out. We're like, what's going on right now?
This guy's lifting and trying to spot, and he's like, oh, hold on, man.
Priorities.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Like, you can manage this. I got a Squirtle.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, a couple random silly questions, because we're at Comic-Con, and we're talking about all sorts of, as if these other questions have been serious. We talk about all kind of different universes at Comic-Con, the Star Wars universe, Lord of the Rings, whatever, Star Trek. What universe would you yourself, the actual human being sitting before me, want to live in?
Star Trek.
You want to live in the Star Trek world?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's really cool.
It's pretty cool.
All of them. The movies, the TV show, everything.
You're into it all.
Oh,
I respect that.
Yeah, thank you.
Anything for you guys?
Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, that's the one.
You saw that coming? You saw that?
I might have heard about it.
I love it. So what? But only if I can be Aragorn, though.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
that's the coolest guy on the
planet. Absolutely.
Like, 100%. A longer life, but not immortality, because I'd get really bored.
Yeah.
But, like, I can handle, like, the 200, 300-year thing. Like, I'm all for
100%,
that.
100%, me too.
Yeah, I feel like you've thought about this for a while. You've been dreaming of this. We'll get this done, okay.
That's why I started acting.
To get into...
It's a great...
To be Aragorn.
To get to be Aragorn.
I wish.
For you, Eli?
I'd go with two. The original Matrix, not the sequels. Mm-hmm. If I could be in that universe,
awesome.
Or Star Wars.
Star Wars,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Pretty cool.
You are in the Matrix. I hate to.
Which field do you want to take?
I know kung fu.
The presidential election. What superhero would make the best president? You think if we're electing?
Truth Man.
The new superhero. We need Truth
Someone
Man.
Someone who could just be like, that's not true. I know, because I'm Truth Man.
Right, Fact Checker Man.
Yeah, Fact Checker Man.
That's terrifying. They'd never elect Superman because he's an alien immigrant.
Whoa. That's a great
Batman's a capitalist, so no.
Provocative question, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. What?
Oh, yeah, we did Wonder Woman because she's got the belt of truth, yeah? The lasso of truth.
She's got the lasso of truth. That could
work. Yeah, all right.
She's already got a cool plan.
But
she doesn't need Air Force One.
People are already having trouble swallowing the idea of a woman as president. So one that actually had to abuse you to get the truth out of you might not go over so well.
This is
a deep hole. We've gone down a really deep. I'm going to think about this really hard and tweet this later so y'all can find out who I decided.
Frankly, it's way deeper than
I imagined. It might just be the Joker, and I'm like, anarchy.
No.
You're like a lovely, easy question.
I meant it to be simple, but it's hard. Okay.
That's what she said.
Oh, come on. Come on.
She did it. She did it.
You're the only one I've done it.
Usually I do it all the time.
I'm privileged, thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a Comic-Con tradition for us. For years we've been doing this. At the end of every interview, we play a game called Geeks and Posers, where we separate the true geeks from posers with a little trivia.
Okay.
Let's see what happens.
Okay.
I feel like judging from some of your answers already, you're gonna be okay, Zelda.
We elect Zelda.
No, but this is where things go bad.
No, it's not gonna go bad. It's not gonna go
bad.
I'm
scared.
You can refuse to answer.
That's true.
No, she can't.
Just follow politics.
Okay.
I'll just call you a poser.
Okay, we're gonna start easy. Who are Kylo Ren's parents?
I know this one.
Go for it.
No,
so you go.
No, because this is an easy one. No, you guys do this one. I want the hard one.
No, go for it.
I want the really hard one.
You're going to answer all of them. Don't worry.
Yeah, I know. You're going to answer everything. Go.
No!
We elect you.
You know who it is.
Go. You go.
It's your turn.
Yeah, it's all you. I'm not going.
You're in first in line.
No, yeah, I agree.
You know the answer.
At the kind of...
Yeah, but you guys know it too.
Why don't you say it in unison? In unison.
Yeah, we have. Go ahead.
No!
Yeah, it's all you.
I'm worried that Elizabeth doesn't know and she's trying to foist it on you now.
This is a play. She doesn't actually know. This is just, oh yeah, of course, everyone knows that one.
It's, you know, it's Leia. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, there you go. Let's go.
It's really sad.
It's really sad.
No, it's all good. Okay.
He's also super emo.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, he's
this is a little tougher. Marvel Universe, what is Mjolnir?
It's the hammer of Thor.
Nice.
Because well I also love it in the movie where she goes, what's meow meow?
Walking Dead question. What is Negan's weapon of choice?
Negan. Is he the
recent edition, this last Jeffrey Dean Morgan?
Oh, it's the bat with the wire on it.
Oh, the thing that's in the elevator. Yeah.
I don't watch that show, but that bat is everywhere.
It is.
Yeah.
Lord of the Rings question.
Yes.
Where did Frodo and Sam go to destroy the One Ring?
Mordor.
Yeah, it's not a trick question. Yeah. It's like beneath Zelda. She doesn't even want to answer. It's
no,
so easy.
I was like, wait,
I want to
know the
trick.
Yeah.
I was like, is there an even star question coming?
Fast and Furious, give me your best Vin Diesel impression.
Oh, I am Groot.
That's great.
And finally, can anybody here sing the Pokemon theme song?
I can.
Do it.
Let's do it.
This is going to be super embarrassing. This is going to haunt me.
No, it won't.
And my future imaginary children.
Yeah.
I want to be the very best, like no one ever was. To catch them is my real test.
Oh, she's
to claim them is my cause. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide.
Wow. That was amazing. Drop the mic.
Drop the mic.
The cast of Dead of Summer. Thanks for watching this Facebook Live. Check out Dead of Summer on Freeform. Thanks for stopping by, guys.
I'm gonna regret that one.
No, not really.
That was so cool.
That was amazing. Best rendition thus far.